Hello aspirants, welcome to Tathagata online classes. Today we are coming up with a new series, top MCQs related to current affair. In this video, this is the first part of that series. This is an English medium video. Kannada madhyamadalli ee video series annu naavu namma YouTube channel alli upload maduttive. ನೀವು ಯಾರಾದರೂ ನಮ್ಮ ಚಾನಲ್ಗೆ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದರೆ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ಆಗಿ, ಅದರಿಂದ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಕನ್ನಡ ಮಾಧ್ಯಮದಲ್ಲಿಯೂ ಕೂಡ ಈ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಸಿರೀಸ್ ನಿಮ್ಮ ನೀವು ಅದರ ಸದುಪಯೋಗವನ್ನು ಪಡೆದುಕೊಳ್ಳಬಹುದು. ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ. ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಜುಲೈ ಟು ಡಿಸೆಂಬರ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಅಫೇರ್ MCQs. Okay, don't skip this video because from first 1 to 20, around 20 questions, we have included direct simple current affair questions. After that, the level of toughness of the questions will be higher compared to earlier ones, because recently conducted exam by KSP and also KPSC. The question paper level is bit more higher compared to previous year, so we should have the deeper knowledge about the deeper understanding of about the current affair related news. So here first question: which railway station received a 5-star Eat Right certification recently? Okay, here what is 5-star Eat Right certification? Eat Right station certification is provided by the FSSAI, means Food Safety and Security Authority of India, FSSAI. Upon the conclusion of whatever the nutritious, high quality nutritious food provided to the customer in the railway station, it is concluded by FSSAI and paneled third party audit agency. The third party organization will conduct a audit. On that audit, FSSAI will give the 5-star rating. Okay, 5-star EAT certification certification will be given by FSSAI. So here, which railway station bagged this award? Chandigarh. Next question: which among the following built Hansa new generation aircraft? Hansa new generation aircraft, it is developed by CSIRNAL. Okay. Next, third one: one year movement is related to which state? 1 year movement is related to Tamil Nadu. 1 year movement was organized in Tamil Nadu. 1 years are the community located in Tamil Nadu. 1 year is a community located in Tamil Nadu. The movement was started in 1987. Next, fourth one: which state bar UT started a Sat initiative? Sat initiative, it is started by Jammu and Kashmir. Sat initiative is to help the SHGs, women SHGs. The loan is provided to them to start the self-help group and empower the women in the J&K, Jammu and Kashmir. Next question. Constitution static part: which article speaks about appointment of High Court judges? Article 217, it is related to appointment of High Court judges. High Court judges are appointed by President with consultation of a collegium consisting of CJI plus two senior most judges and governor of that state. Next question: सिम्बेक्स इज अ मिलिट्री एक्सरसाइज, सिम्बेक्स इज अ मिलिट्री एक्सरसाइज बिटवीन इंडिया एंड सिंगापुर, मिलिट्री एक्सरसाइज. ओके, यू हैव टू मेक अ टेबल ऑफ दैट मिलिट्री एक्सरसाइज सो दैट वी विल गेट रिमेंबर ऑफ ऑल दीज एक्सरसाइज कंडक्टेड बाई इंडिया एंड अदर कंट्री. सेवेंथ वन, वेर इज ईस्टर्न इकोनॉमिक फोरम सेशन हेल्ड एवरी ईयर. ओके, ईस्टर्न इकोनॉमिक फोरम इट इज हेल्ड इन रशिया. नेक्स्ट, ईस्टर्न इकोनॉमिक फोरम हेल्ड इन रशिया. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, द कर्बी एथनिक कम्युनिटी, वेर एवर द एक्सप्लेनेशन आई एम गिविंग द एक्सप्लेनेशन डायरेक्ट फैक्चुअल क्वेश्चन यू शुड रिमेंबर दैट वन. द कर्बी एथनिक कम्युनिटी बिलोंग्स टू विच स्टेट. ओके, कर्बी एथनिक कम्युनिटी, दिस वन इज अ फैक्चुअल फैक्चुअल करंट अफेयर क्वेश्चन बिकॉज कर्बी एंगलोंग कम्युनिटी इज इन न्यूज. द कम्युनिटी बिलोंग्स टू विच स्टेट, आसाम. नेक्स्ट, विच स्टेट बार यूटी रिपोर्टेड द फर्स्ट आउटब्रेक ऑफ निफा वायरस इन इंडिया. ओके, हियर निफा वायरस इन इंडिया फर्स्ट आउटब्रेक वेयर इट हैपन इन वेस्ट बंगाल इन द ईयर 2007. विच इज द फर्स्ट कंट्री टू लॉन्च प्लास्टिक पैक्ट. इंडिया, इंडिया इज द फर्स्ट कंट्री इन द वर्ल्ड टू लॉन्च अ प्लास्टिक पैक्ट टू कर्व द प्लास्टिक पोल्यूशन. ओके, नेक्स्ट, ASER report is related to which of the following sector? ASER full for you comment below, mention in the comment section. It is related to education sector, released by NGO Pratham. Pratham is a NGO, they are releasing this one. ASER report. Next, which railway station, this is a repeated question again, Chandigarh, which is the state animal of Ladakh, very popular in the news. Ladakh state animal is clouded leopard. Clouded leopard is endangered status in IUCN red list. Next, which country is organizer of Zapad exercise? Which country is organizer of Zapad exercise? Russia. Zapad exercise 2021. It is a multi-nation exercise led by Russia. Okay, multi-nation exercise led by Russia. It is a one of the theater level the exercise of Russian armed forces and will focus preliminarily on the operations against terrorism, it is a anti-terrorism operation, anti-terrorism exercise. Which of the following is, now we have to read correct question properly. Which of the following is not a part of collaboration launched by UBREATH? What is UBREATH? UBREATH is a living plant, living like plant, the artificially developed plant. It works like a living plant. Okay. It is a collaboration of IIT Kanpur, IIT Roper and Delhi University. Here IIS is not involved. Okay, they have asked not a part of collaboration of UBREATH. IIS is not a part of collaboration in the development of UBREATH. UBREATH is a collaborative initiative of IIT Kanpur, IIT Roper and Delhi University. Next, 16th one. Where is the Chengdu province is located? China. When is the International Day of Charity celebrated? International Day of Charity is celebrated on September 5 to commemorate birth anniversary of Mother Teresa. Mother Teresa. Next one. The Partnership Action on Green Economy. Partnership Action on Green Economy, meaning PAGE. Okay, PAGE is a UN mechanism to assist countries transition towards greener and more inclusive economy. Emerged at which conference? PAGE. PAGE means Partnership on Action on Green Economy, a mechanism to assist countries transition towards greener economy, means greener economies and more inclusive economies. It is emerged at UN Conference on Sustainable Development 2012 Rio de Janeiro. Means it is also called as Rio Plus 20 Summit. Option 2B is the right answer. Next, in which year Vidyanjali scheme launched? About this Vidyanjali, in UPSC IAS 2017, they have asked question. In which year the Vidyanjali scheme was launched? Answer is 2017. It is a program of Ministry of Education. Next question. Which state has decided to celebrate Periyar's birthday? Periyar's birthday as a Social Justice Day. Periyar's birthday as Social Justice Day. Here, correct answer is Tamil Nadu. Correct answer is Tamil Nadu. Option D. Tamil Nadu is the right answer. Periyar's birthday as a Social Justice Day in that state. Social Justice Day in that state, Tamil Nadu. Which state bar UT launched a Business Blaster program? Business Blaster program launched in Delhi. Business Blaster program launched in Delhi. Next, which state celebrates Himalaya Divas? Himalaya Divas is celebrated by Uttarakhand. Uttarakhand celebrates as a Himalaya Divas. You mention below on which day we celebrate as a Himalaya Divas. Mention date in the comment section. When is the International Day of Literacy celebrated every year? International Day of Literacy, September 8. Which state bar UT launched Medicines from Sky program? Medicines from Sky program launched by Telangana in Hyderabad city. Okay, related to this news, iDrone by ICMR for COVID vaccination. COVID vaccination outreach in the northeastern region. First, Manipur, in the Manipur state, vaccine through drone. This program is launched in Manipur by ICMR. Vaccine through drone. Drone name is iDrone, made in India only. Launched in Manipur state. Next question. The report titled Inequality Kills, very important. Inequality Kills, the unparalleled action needed to combat unprecedented inequality in the wake of COVID-19 is released by Oxfam. Oxfam is a think tank. It is based in यूके। ऑक्सफैम रिलीज्ड विच रिपोर्ट, इनइक्वालिटी किल्स द अनपैरेलल्ड एक्शन नीडेड टू कॉम्बैट अनप्रेसिडेंटेड इनइक्वालिटी इन द वेक ऑफ कोविड 19। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, डिजास्टर्स रिसीव्ड डिजास्टर्स कवर्ड अंडर स्टेट डिजास्टर रेस्पॉन्स फंड SDRF, हेलस्ट्रॉम क्लाउड बर्स्ट पेस्ट अटैक फोर्स्ट ऑल आर इंक्लूडेड इन द SDRF प्रोग्राम। ओके, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन सी हियर द क्वेश्चन लेवल विल बी हायर फ्रॉम नाउ ऑनवर्ड्स। कंसीडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट, अकॉर्डिंग टू द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया द स्टेट विच ग्रांटिंग व्हाइल ग्रांटिंग एड टू एजुकेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशंस shall not discriminate against the any educational institution on the ground that it is under the management of minority, whether based on religion or language. Okay, this is the first statement. Next, second statement, the report to get the government aid for an educational institution run by a minority community is a fundamental right. Which of the above statement is bar or correct? Okay, here first statement is correct because it is a fundamental right related to educational institution. It is a fundamental right, correct. But in second statement, you observe carefully here, right to get a government aid for a educational institution run by a minority community is not a fundamental right. Okay, minority institutions are based on linguistic or religious type of institution, whichever type, it will get entitled grants, but it is not a fundamental right. Okay, right to get a government aid is not a fundamental right. So here only one is the correct answer. Only one, statement one is the right answer, statement two is wrong. So only one right answer. Next question, consider the following statement regarding the Akash Prime missile in PSI 545 post exam. Agni Prime question asked, same type of question here we have mentioned. Okay, what is this question? Akash Prime missile, not Agni Prime missile. Very important question it is, very very important. Akash Prime missile, it is a new version of Akash surface to air missile. It is equipped with the indigenous active radio frequency seeker for the improved accuracy. It can function under low temperature environment at a higher altitude. Okay, higher altitude radio frequency seeker. Here all statements are correct. 1, 2, 3, all are correct here. Next one, the Indian Army commemorates September 23 every year as a Haifa Day to pay its respect to three Indian cavalry regiment that helped to liberate Haifa. In these three Indian cavalry, Mysore Infantry cavalry is also one of the three regiments that helped to liberate Haifa. Haifa is located in which region? Okay, Haifa is located in Israel. September 23, Haifa Day. So Haifa is located in Israel. Next question, which of these African states border with the Mediterranean Sea? World geography, current news. Here, Tunisia and Egypt these two African states border with the Mediterranean Sea? So option one, option A 1 and 2 is the right answer. Next, 31st question. Agalaga Islands and Assumption Island, sometimes seen in the news, is located in which ocean? Indian Ocean. Located in Indian Ocean. Consider the following statement regarding the transfer payment, economy, current affair. Following regarding the transfer payments. Transfer payments are received which the residents of the country receive for free. Okay. Next, they consist of remittance, gifts and grants. Third one, they could given by the government or private citizen living abroad. Okay. Here all three statements are correct regarding the transfer payments. So option D 1, 2, 3 is the right answer. Next one, Utkarsh 2022, often seen in the news. Utkarsh 2022, often seen in the news, is related to Utkarsh 2022 is related to banking sector, banking scheme. It is a banking system. In this, what we will do? In this Utkarsh 2022, RBI board has finalized 3-year roadmap. 3-year roadmap to improve the regulation and supervision among the functions of the central bank. It is a roadmap for medium term objective to be achieved for improving regulation supervision of the central bank. Okay, it is related to regulation and the supervision of central bank. It is a plan, it will strengthen the regulatory mechanism of the central bank. So okay, it is simply regulation and the supervisory mechanism of central bank. The board finalized by RBI board. Next, 34th, new arrangement to borrow means NAB funding mechanism recently seen in the news is related to which bank? NAB is related to IMF, International Monetary Fund. New arrangement of board, it is a mechanism related to IMF. Here NAB is a fund mobilization arrangement. Fund mobilization arrangement by IMF to mobilize the additional funds through borrowing from the member countries. Additional fund borrowing from the member countries. It is related by mechanism by IMF. Next, 35th question. Which of the following statement about enforcement directorate is incorrect? Enforcement directorate is incorrect. ED is appointed on the approval of appointment of committee of cabinet headed by the prime minister is correct one. Next, second one, it is a function under the aegis of Central Bureau of Investigation. Next, C, it is responsible for tracking the black money and hawala trade cases. Option C is the correct one. Option B here is the wrong. So they asked the incorrect statement. So it is a function under the aegis of CBI is the wrong one. What is correct here is ED, Enforcement Directorate, is a function. It functions under aegis of Department of Revenue, Ministry of Finance. It functions under Department of Revenue, Ministry of Finance. It is a law enforcement agency and economic intelligence agency responsible for enforcing economic law and fighting economic crimes in India. Okay, it is combat the economic crime is a main function of enforcement directorate. It has a mandate to enforce two most stringent law in the country. They are PMLA means Prevention of Money Laundering. PMLA means Prevention of Money Laundering Act. Second one is FEMA, FEMA, Foreign Exchange Management Act, to check the black money and hawala trade cases. So third one and first one correct, so second one is incorrect. Next, 36th, among the following acts, department, again say similar question, here enforcement directorate is most concerned with which among the following act. I have mentioned in the above explanation that enforcement directed has a mandate to enforce two most stringent law in India. Those are PMLA, Prevention of Money Laundering Act, and FEMA, Foreign Exchange Management Act. Here they are what we'll check the options here. Here, according to that explanation, correct answer is Prevention of Money Laundering Act, PMLA, Prevention of Money Laundering Act. Next, 37th question, a SWIFT code, sometimes seen in the news, is related to. SWIFT code is related to option A, International Banking Transaction. What is SWIFT? SWIFT is a full form of SWIFT is Society, I will write it down, Society for Worldwide Interbank Financial Telecommunication. SWIFT, it is a secure financial message carrier. It transports a message from one bank, from one central bank to intended other bank request recipient. Its core role is to provide a secure transmission channel between two banks. It is a secure transmission channel. Next, specified financial transactions recently seen in the news is related to what? Specified financial transaction is related to high value transaction undertaken by the citizen which will be tracked by the government. Okay, specified financial transaction are certain high value transactions undertaken by the citizen that the government proposes to track with intent to curb black money and hawala transactions, so that we will widen the tax base in India. Okay, to widen the tax base in India, specified financial transactions are tracked by the government for the high value transaction. Next question, consider the following statement regarding the TREDS, means trade receivable discounting system. First statement here is TREDS is an electronic platform. TREDS is an electronic platform facilitating a financing and discounting of a trade receivable of micro, small and medium, means MSME, through multiple financiers. Only MSME can participate as a seller in TREDS. banks and NBFCs can participate financiers in trades. Here, correct, all above statements are correct. The statements itself are the explanatory in nature. Trades is an electronic platform for facilitating the financing and discounting. It is an electronic platform. Next, it is for MSME. Okay. MSME through these receivables can be due from corporates and other buyers, including government departments and public sector undertakings. Okay. MSMEs can participate in the sellers in the trades. Second statement also correct. Banks and NBFCs can participate as a financiers in the trades. So third also, it is the intermediaries for the transaction between two parties, banks and NBFCs. Next question, consider the following statement regarding the food safety mitra. Very important, food safety mitra. Here first statement, in a bid to improve the ease of doing business, FSSAI, Food Safety and Standard Authority of India, launched a scheme Food Safety Mitra. Correct statement. Next, second one, the scheme will mainly support large scale food businesses in compliance to the food safety law. This is the wrong statement. Here correct is only one. In a bid to improve the ease of doing business, first statement is correct, no question about that. In a bid to improve the ease of doing business, food apex means apex food regulator of India is FSSAI. It is a scheme launched by FSSAI. FSM means Food Safety Mitra. This scheme will support small and medium scale companies to comply the safety law. Here what they have mentioned, it is a wrong. Large scale is not a correct. The scheme is mainly support small and medium enterprises. Next question, consider the statement regarding the Samudrayana project. Samudrayana project, first statement, it is a pilot project of Ministry of Earth Science for deep ocean mining of rare minerals. It proposes to send human to deep sea in submersible devices, submersible vehicles for ocean studies. Correct one. This project is undertaken by ISRO. Here first statement, pilot project of Ministry of Earth Science is the correct one. Samudrayana project is project of Ministry of Earth Science. It proposes to send a human. It is also correct statement. So project undertaken by ISRO is the wrong here. Only 1 and 2 are the correct statements. Because this project has been undertaken by National Institute of Ocean Technology. National Institute of Ocean Technology, not by ISRO. So third statement will be wrong, incorrect. So statement 1 and 2, option C is the right answer. It is a pilot project of Ministry of Earth Science, and the project is expected to come in reality by 2022. Next question, consider the following statement regarding Mission Parivar Vikas. Mission Parivar Vikas is a family planning program aimed to establish a population aim to stabilize the population growth in all the states in the country. We will see about this statement. Next, second statement, the objective of the mission is to accelerate access to high quality family planning choices based on information, reliable services and supplies within right based framework. Here, first statement, here all the state of the country is the wrong one. All the state, it, this mission Parivar Vikas is not for all the state of country. It is only for what? Only where TFR means total fertility rate is higher, no? Total 7 state where TFR is higher, in those states only this mission Parivar Vikas will be implementing. The Union Ministry of Health and Family Welfare launched Mission Parivar Vikas for improved family planning services in the 7 high focused states. Okay, this family planning is based on right based activities. So statement 2 will be correct one. Here the third one, the goal is to reduce total fertility rate and bring it to 2.1 by 2025. Total fertility rate 2.1 by 2025 is the right statement. So here 2 and 3 is the right one. 2 and 3 is the right one. TFR, total fertility rate, is the main aim of this scheme is to bring down the total fertility rate to 2.1. 1.1 for female and for male 1 means replacement whatever population it will get replaced by how much means 2.1 is the meaning of that total fertility rate. They are whatever current highest total fertility rate in these 7 states, it constitutes 44% of total fertility rate by the total fertility in the country. These 7 state constitutes total 44% of India's fertility rate. Okay, next question. Consider the following statement regarding the recently launched Chunauti statement. Okay, Chunauti program, sorry. Chunauti is a next generation startup challenge contest launched by Ministry of Electronic and Information Technology. Right one. It aims to boost the startup and software product with a special focus on tier 2 towns in India. Both statement is correct one. What they asked, which of the above statement are incorrect? Neither one nor two is the incorrect, because both are correct here. They have asked incorrect statement. Consider the statement regarding the Mission Karma Yogi, very famous program. Mission Karma Yogi is a new capacity building scheme for civil service aimed at upgrading the post recruitment training mechanism. Correct statement. Mission Karma Yogi program will be delivered through digital platform called I Got Karma Yogi. It is absolutely right. Capacity Building Commission will prepare and monitor annual capacity building plan and audit human resource available in the government. This is also correct statement. So all the above are correct one here. 1, 2, 3. Correct one. We will increase the speed here. SANS campaign, sometimes seen in the news, is related to reducing the child mortality due to pneumonia. What is the full form of SANS? सोशल अवेयरनेस एंड एक्शन टू न्यूट्रलाइज निमोनिया सक्सेसफुली. न्यूट्रलाइज निमोनिया सक्सेसफुली इट इज अ फुल फॉर्म ऑफ कैंपेन दिस सांस. द मेन एम ऑफ दिस इज टू रिड्यूस द चाइल्ड मोर्टेलिटी ड्यू टू निमोनिया. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, RAIDERX recently seen in the news is related to, it is a explosive detection device by DRDO. RAIDERX is a explosive detection devices. Next, NASA's sonification program recently seen in the news is related to, transforming astronomical images into music. Sonification project means astronomical images into music. You have come across this word telescope, means James Webb and also Hubble Space Telescope by NASA. It will capture the astronomical image and send it to us. But recently, sonification project here in this transforming the astronomical image into music file, MP3 file or audio file. We can listen that audio and imagine the astronomical image. This is the sonification project. Next, the term brute force acquisition is related to, it is related to mobile device forensics. It is a brute force acquisition is related to mobile devices forensics. Okay, next, consider the following statement regarding the Baba Kavach. Baba Kavach is India's lightest bulletproof jacket which can withstand a bullet from AK-47. Correct one. It is developed by DRDO. It is a wrong statement. Jacket is powered with the nanotechnology from Baba Atomic Research Center, BARC. Here 1 and 3 are the correct one. Baba Kavach is developed jointly by Ordnance Factory Board and a public sector undertaking of metal and metal alloys manufacturers Medhani PSU and Ordnance Factory Board are developed this Baba Kavach. Next one, E2020 initiative launched by WHO is regarding, it is malaria elimination. E2020 initiative by WHO is regarding malaria elimination. Next one, Oslo Accord, sometime in the scene news in the, related to which of these countries? It is related to Israel Palestine. Oslo Accord came into force in 1993. Hague Code of Conduct, HCOC, sometimes seen in the news, is related to prevention of proliferation of ballistic missile. Prevention of proliferation of ballistic missile. Okay, Hague Code of Conduct. Next, momentum of charge is an initiative of UN Climate Change Secretariat. Okay, it is for greener economy. Interpol's declared policing goals to include which of these? Okay, correct statement here is providing a secure cyberspace for people, curbing illicit market, supporting environment friendly. All 1, 2, 3 are the correct statement here. Interpol headquarters is in Lyon, Sierra Leone. 1, 2, 3. Next, again same repeated question. We will skip that one. Budapest Convention sometimes seen in the news is related to, it is related to cyber security. Budapest Convention, it is one of the oldest convention related to cyber security, and we can also consider it the first international convention for the cyber security curve. ओके नेक्स्ट कोविड 19 एक्शन रेस्पॉन्स एंड एक्सपेंडिचर सपोर्ट प्रोग्राम केयर्स प्रोग्राम इज इनिशिएटिव ऑफ एशियन डेवलपमेंट बैंक. कोविड 19 एक्शन रेस्पॉन्स एंड एक्सपेंडिचर सपोर्ट प्रोग्राम इज इनिशिएटिव ऑफ एशियन डेवलपमेंट बैंक. नेक्स्ट ग्लोबल सिक्योरिटी मोबिलिटी रिपोर्ट. ग्लोबल सोशल मोबिलिटी रिपोर्ट इज रिलीज्ड बाय इट इज रिलीज्ड बाय वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमिक फोरम. वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमिक फोरम. नेक्स्ट कोविड 19 रिस्क आउटलुक अ प्रिलिमिनरी मैपिंग एंड इम्प्लीकेशन इज पब्लिश्ड बाय विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इट इज ऑल्सो वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमिक फोरम. नेक्स्ट वन दोमेरिया आइलैंड. दोमेरिया आइलैंड. दोमेरिया आइलैंड समटाइम्स इन सीन इन द न्यूज इज लोकेटेड इन रेड सी. विच ऑफ दीज वाटर बॉडीज विटनेसेस सनराइज एट अर्लीएस्ट कैस्पियन सी बिकॉज इट इज द मोस्ट ईस्टर्न लोकेटेड इन द ईस्टर्न साइड ऑफ वर्ल्ड. सो sun will be we witness sun rising at earliest in Caspian Sea in the in our compared to others. Next one Kunduz, Gormuz and Ghazni often seen in the news is located in Afghanistan. Next one Okzul glacier recently seen in the news is located in Iceland. These are factual very important current affair questions. Which ministry launched a digital population clock? Ministry of Health. Digital population clock, it will measure all the rates means MMR, IMR, infant mortality rate and other health indicators. It is launched by Ministry of Health. Where is the Sardam Bhavan situated? Ahmedabad. Where is the world's largest plant to suck the carbon dioxide planet to build? Iceland. Okay, in Iceland, very important here, this one, to suck the carbon dioxide, Iceland has built the world's largest plant. Which of the following country is the biggest meat exporter of European Union? Netherlands. Next one. Which is the first country to pass the law to make a mandatory for, very important, way mandatory for new homes to have the electrical vehicle chargers? Compulsory in home we should have the electrical vehicle chargers. In which country? England. Which Indian state established a course on Ramacharita Manasa? Madhya Pradesh. In Madhya Pradesh for BA degree first year the course included is related to Ramacharita Manasa. Who wrote Ramacharita Manasa? You comment in the below. Comment below. Okay. When is the National Hindi Day celebrated? National Hindi Day celebrated on September 14. Which city launched a QR facility for waste collection? Noida. In Noida, QR facility for waste collection. Which of the following started a mission Shunya? Mission Shunya started by Niti Aayog. This Mission Shunya is an initiative to promote a zero pollution delivery vehicle by working with consumer and industry. It means zero pollution. Aim is to make a zero pollution by the delivery vehicles. And it is main aim is to accelerate further adaptation of improve the adaptation of electrical vehicle for the urban deliveries and from this we will benefit about zero pollution delivery. Next one, in which year India joined Shanghai Cooperation Organization 2017 along with Pakistan? India and Pakistan joined on same year. Which institution launched SK Joshi Lab Excellence Award? Quality Council of India. The award by the Quality Council of India. Who constitutes GST Council of India? President constitutes the GST Council. Okay. GST Council constituted by President according to Article 279 of 1. Okay. Then who chairs the GST Council? Who is the chairman of GST Council? Finance Minister. Which of the following institution launched a SPIN program? SPIN program is launched by KVIC, Khadi Village and Industrial Corporation. When is the Bombay-Delhi Expressway? Bombay-Delhi Expressway expected to be completed. It is completed by 2023. When it gets completed, it will be the longest expressway in India. At present, longest expressway is Purvanchal Expressway. But when Bombay-Delhi Expressway construction completed, it will be the longest expressway in India. It will be completed by 2023. Next question, which education tech giant has partnered with the Niti Aayog to provide a free education to the children in the aspirational districts? Byju's. Byju's collaborated with Niti Aayog. Recently, by Botanical Survey of India, discovered a wild variety of banana Musa Paradhini from which place it discovered Darjeeling. Who releases the Global Innovation Index? Global Innovation Index is released WIPO along with INSEAD and Cornell University. Vayoshrestha Samman is an award given to the states in which category? It is related to geriatric care, means elderly care. The award is won by Kerala, first rank by Kerala. It is a geriatric care. Landsat is a mission of which space? NASA. It is a Earth observatory mission by NASA. Which ministry launched a Digi Saksham? Ministry of Labor and Employment. Digi Saksham campaign launched by Ministry of Labor and Employment. Which ministry launched a Sacred Portal? Sacred Portal launched by Ministry of Social Justice. The main aim of this Sacred Portal is to provide employment to senior citizens. The main aim is to provide employment to senior citizen, which is launched by Ministry of Social Justice. Which country is celebrating National Day for Truth and Reconciliation? Truth and Reconciliation by Canada. Okay. Next. At which place the world's longest national flag displayed? Leh. By KVIC. Khadi Village Industrial Corporation. Leh is the place in which the world's longest Indian national flag displayed. Next, artemisinin is a medicine used to treat which disease? Malaria. Next one, FSSAI has set up which year as a guideline to make India trans fat free 2022. Next one, CRISPM tool seen in the news embeds a climate information in which of the following schemes? It is MGNREGA. In MGNREGA, we use CRISPM tool to monitor the work done in the rural areas. Deep atomic clock, which was seen in the news. Deep space atomic clock seen in the news associated with which space agency? Okay, deep space atomic clock is related to NASA. Next one, which public sector unit has recently accorded Maharatna status? Power Finance Corporation of India, PFC. So at present there are 10 Maharatna companies are there. Okay. Next, 93rd, Union Home Ministry began tripartite talk with Gurkha regiment, Gurkha representative and which state government? West Bengal. Union Home Ministry, Gurkha and West Bengal, tripartite talks. Which Indian state were launched a patrolling operation called Operation Satark? Operation Satark has been launched in New Delhi. Next, Sela Tunnel. 95th question. Sorry, one second. I'll come back. 95th, Sela Tunnel, seen in the news, is located in which Indian state? Arunachal Pradesh. Next, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam Prerna Sthal, inaugurated at the Naval Science and Technological Laboratory, located in which city? Visakhapatnam. Next one, as per the study conducted by the Council of Energy, Environment and Water, which state bar UT tops in electrical cooking? Delhi and Tamil Nadu. Delhi is a UT, Tamil Nadu is in state category. Okay. In state category, Tamil Nadu. In UT, Union Territory category, Delhi. Next, consider the following statement. Sovarigpa or a science of healing is based on indigenous medicine of Tibet. Correct one. Hippocrates is considered as a father of Sovarigpa or science of healing is the wrong one. Here, father of Sovarigpa, we believed that Yuthog, Yonten, Gonpo. He is considered as a father of Sovarigpa. Here only one statement is correct. Second statement is wrong one. Ayush One, a dedicated forest Ayurvedic plant, is inaugurated in which state? Gujarat. Next, last question. The South Sethia region was seen in the news recently, is located in the option A, Antarctica, B, Arctic, C, Great Himalaya, D, none of the above. Here, correct answer is none of the above. Then, where South Sethia is located? Recently, you came across NASA's Perseverance rover in the Mars, which launched into the Mars. It has clicked a panoramic view in Mars. panoramic view in the Mars. Panoramic view in the Mars called South Sethia region. It is called as a South Sethia region. So NASA's Perseverance rover clicked panoramic view of South Sethia region of Mars Jezero crater. Here, see how many information is there. You check South Sethia region in the Mars in Jezero crater clicked by Perseverance rover. That area is called as a mysterious past, means South Sethia. The meaning is mysterious past. Mysterious past. Okay. So, here correct answer option is not given. So, correct answer none of the above. Thank you very much. If you did not subscribe, you are not subscribed to my channel, subscribe. And thanks for watching. Thank you. You share with your friends.